Don't know why I act the way I do. Like I ain't got a single thing to lose. Sometimes I'm my own worst enemy. I guess that's just the cowboy in me.
Always seek adventure in farming and birds and goats and camping. Well, guys, this is my new to me 2020 Forest River Alpha Wolf Cherokee, or Cherokee Alpha Wolf, however you want to say it. This is a sharp coach. I'm telling you, when I was watching the videos about these things and researching it, everybody calls them a coach. I don't like the door doesn't have a window. Drives me up the wall, but I can get one. They're like $500. So the whole door is a window. And I think that's pretty cool. On the outside here, it is a very, very sleek looking camper. It's got the blue LED lights up there. They got to be changed out. Super simple. There's a track. You just slide out those and slide out cheap Amazon lights right back in. No big deal. God, where can I start? It is prepped for solar. It doesn't have a solar controller right now, but I can do a single 50 watt just to maintain my battery. And I'm gonna tell you, somebody really fucked up when they put these on here. Those are not accurate at all. Because, I mean, if you look at this, as it spins, yeah, that's another story. But anyway, it is a sharp camper. I like it because it's got a molded front nose cone. That is really good. I like that. I like that better than having metal or whatever and it's flat. This seems to be a little bit more aerodynamic. It's got the cool blue front lights, blue glow. It's got an electric jack, which is really cool. It's got one super slide on it, which is great. It's a very large slide. You can see the side of this thing. It's flawless. There's no D-Lam, none of that stuff. It is come stock with LED lights all the way around. Slam latches, but magnetic. So that's cool. So these shut like that. Downfall. One thing I don't like about it is cable driven slide out. I hate them, but that's what I got in this. I usually prefer the hydraulic or the electric screw mechanism underneath. Those are foolproof. You know, this side here, it has got the nice big slide out. I had them put a slide topper on because I don't, every time I get a new RV now, I've just been, if it doesn't come with one, I have it put on. The last one had one put on, actually, so that was really convenient, really nice. It's got, that window opens, these windows open. It's a very, very nice rig. No door for the bathroom over here in the back like the other one had. No big deal. I like that it's got this kind of twist lock with the 90 for that. I gotta get a 90 for the hose. It is leaking a little. Outside shower. I gotta get the key to close that. I wish and do that. But it's got a cool type of black water, black tank flush. It twirls around. Again, it's a flawless camper. No D-Lam. It's, and it really can't because of the way it is. Right. The way it is, it's a, I don't know how to explain it to you, but it's like my Montana was. It's like a compressed composite style thing. Got it from Cookville RV and Marine. They treated us like kings and queen. So I come over here to the thing that my wife likes about it. My wife, you know, we were going to get a toy hauler, but we just, they're a lot of money. So, what do we got here? We got big fridge. little freezer spot up there, not like you need it. But outside sink, drains into the main system, hot and cold water, blue LED lights, one tap light right there, a drawer for stuff. If I want to put stuff in here, I got a room for stuff. Came with an ice maker. It needs to be cleaned. It is disgusting. But this is, my wife really likes having outside kitchens, you know? So it does have the quick connect for the propane down here somewhere, right there. It came with, they come standard with these stairs. You can see, because it's Grey Wolf. It's even got the Grey Wolf emblem right there. Isn't that cool? It is a Four Seasons camper. Other thing I don't like about new campers, that door. They don't have latches. They're literally just friction doors. They're really hard to get used to. So, Cookeville, Harvey, and Marine. I thought it was going to have the Bluetooth set up on it, but it doesn't. I'm going to turn the water heater off and save some electricity. Yeah, it's kind of a pain in the butt. But I like that. It's really nice. Shoes come off. All the lights. It has all of the lights. So starting with the back here, it has got a great bathroom. A nice big shower. Absolutely great. And I love this. That is probably one of the best shower things I've ever seen. So that's great. I love that. There's a lot of room in there. Me and Angel can take a shower together. Great storage. Yeah, look at this. Look at the storage in here. That is all linen storage. Some things are a little tight like that. More of that blue light. Towel hangers, little accented thing. Heat duct right there. The toilet, which is a glass toilet. Got the light right there. Got me, still my work clothes. Good looking sink. We have this set up right now for my sister-in-law that's coming here. A pantry. Look at this. Look at that. This is a good size pantry. It actually reminds me just like my old cabin cruiser camper I had. It was great. Couch turns into that's a jackknife sofa, and it is super comfortable. I got to get a TV mount still, and I put my sound bar and my boombox out here from the house, and I got a new one for the house with surround sound and whatnot. So the TV mount, it's the small one, and that isn't, it's for like a 30-inch TV. So I got to get one the right size. It did not come with a fireplace. Normally it's a fireplace, but some of them do, some of them don't. A Furrion, all electric, no gas. I kind of like and hate it all at the same time. But what I like about it is all of the room that is in here. So smooth. Look at the freezer room in there. Look at all that room. Yeah. The microwave, because it might have been prepped for a refrigerator or a heater, that switch, because it's 30 amp, if you were to have the heater on, the fireplace heater, you'd have to flip that switch to turn that on. Because you can't run them at the same time. So. But look at this nice fucking stove and cooktop. It's got the cool blue lights again. It's got a glass top. Nice backsplash. That's actually glass. Farm sink. Super cool. Look at this. Yeah. Super neat. Super fucking cool. Is infested with fucking beetles right now. The cool thing about this thing is I fit right here. Even my big fat gut. It's a good camper. It's got these super fancy freaking dining room, dining table lights. Oh yeah, barn doors for the doors, sliding barn doors. Super fancy, super cool. I like the way that is. It is like that on both bathroom door and bedroom door. It's got a 15,000 BTU AC. And this is where all the magic happens. And once again, I can walk around the bed. It's got a lot of room, a lot of storage. I wish that window would open, but it doesn't. It does got a shade though. Super lot of storage. There's storage underneath the bed. I mean, look at this thing. I gotta get a new mattress for it though, because that's the stock one. It's uncomfortable. Emergency door, well, window. USB plugs on both sides, which is great. Oh, check out these freaking, these blinds for this thing. How cool is that? That's pretty nifty. So guys, that's pretty much it. It's got a, you know, even the speakers light up inside and outside. It's got a nice oven. It's not huge, but it, you know, what are you going to do when you're camping? You're going to fucking bake everything, you know? It's got a nice display for the heater and AC. Very easy to use, very self-explanatory. I like that, other than the other ones. It's got an electric awning. I'm not going to put it out because it's fucking windy. Got my dogs out there doing whatever the fuck they're doing. Who knows? And, oh, it is 4-something right now. I've been up ever since 1:30. It's been a long day, guys. But, I just got done slicing bread and slicing pork roast for sandwich meat and sandwiches for the week. I'm really looking forward to getting this thing out and camping in it, RVing. It does have a really nice stereo system. I'm not bummed that it doesn't have a CD player, like a DVD player or a Blu-ray, like the old one did. But the old one didn't work anyway. It's like, fuck it, I don't care. If I want to watch a fucking movie, I'll rent it on Amazon or something. You know, whatever. No big deal. But that is a more in-depth view of this thing. It is a higher end camper, that's for sure. I was a little on the edge about getting Forest River, but I did a lot of research on them. This is an all aluminum framed thing. Everything is aluminum framed except for the roof is wood, which I don't know why they would do that. I don't know why they just wouldn't just make aluminum roof joists, but everything else is aluminum. The walls are 2-inch thick, insulated, foam insulated, not that, stupid cotton candy looking shit. Yeah, it's a great camper. I fucking love this thing. Oh yeah, and if anybody's gonna complain about me swearing, go fuck yourself, you fucking fuck. So, there you have it, guys. In-depth view of the new rig. We are going to take it on a maiden voyage next month, just a quick weekend trip to one of the close state parks around me, because there are so many state parks, it would take me a fucking year to go to all of them. So until we meet again, guys, wait for the maiden voyage, and then directly after that, we are going to Grand Isle, Louisiana. The pickup truck out there is getting a new clutch this Saturday. Another South Bend dual disc clutch, brand new, in the box. I was able to save some money. It was only $1,300, so that's not bad. But, alrighty guys, peace out.